Britannia, Britannia rule the waves. Britons never, never, never will be slaves. Rule Britannia, Britannia rule the waves. Britons never, never, never will be slaves.
Why don't we ask them? Good morning, madam.
Good morning, madam. Good morning, sir.
Can we sit at the table in the corner?
Sure, you can sit wherever you like.
Well, Peter, I had invited James to join us to have a chat and a drink, but unfortunately he's ill. He has the flu.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. I hope he gets well soon.
Well, I'm sure he will. Anyway, let's go and sit down.
Would you like to take a look at the menus?
Yes, please.
Here they are.
Thank you.
I'll be back in a minute to take your orders.
Thank you very much. Hey, Peter, look at the menu. There's some fantastic coffee drinks.
So I see. Can you tell me what a nocciolino is?
Oh, Peter, I really don't know. I think we'll have to ask the bartender.
Okay, I'll have one of those. And you?
Oh, I think I'll have an amaretto, but it depends what it's made of. Excuse me, can you tell me exactly what an amaretto is?
Sure, it's an espresso with amaretto syrup, milk froth, and amaretto crumble biscuits.
Okay, so then, Peter, that's one, what was it? Nocciolino. And one amaretto for me.
Okay, I'll be right back with your orders. Here are your drinks. Please, enjoy.
Oh, thank you very much. This looks delicious.
Are you sure this is the nocciolino?
Well, look, there's an amaretto on the top, but let's taste them and see, okay?
Sometimes it's hard to be a woman. Given.
So, can you tell me more about this place?
Well, Oro Cafe are coffee producers, and the production plant is just behind here. This is actually the factory and the production plant and the offices. And they also have a series of coffee shops under the brand name Adoro Cafe, all over Friuli, and this is one of them. Furthermore, another interesting fact is that we teach their employees English.
Oh, that's interesting. Will I be teaching here too?
Well, probably yes. I think courses will be starting again in November.
Ah, next time I'll try another one.
I will too.
Hi, Irene. Nice to see you here in our Adoro Cafe. How are you doing?
Oh, Stefano, what a surprise to see you in the coffee shop. I thought you would be working in the office.
Lots of hours in the office, but sometimes a good cup of espresso helps me a lot.
Oh, well, we agree. The espresso is fantastic in this shop.
I see you're enjoying a nice macchiato or some special coffees. No, it's not a macchiato.
This is nocciolino.
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 And this
nice.
Is an amaretto. Oh, by the way, Stefano, can I introduce you to Peter?
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Stefano, my pleasure.
Peter is one of our main teachers, and Stefano, Mr. Topano, is the big boss of Oro Cafe.
Ah, the big boss.
Not really. My wife is the big boss. I'm joking.
You're just a worker.
I'm joking. I'm a big worker.
Yeah.
A good worker, but at the end, my wife is still the boss. Where are you from, Peter?
I'm from England, but now I live in Italy. Near to where I work with Business Voice.
Did you
by
like
the
it?
Way, yes, by the way, it's compliments on the coffee, it's very good.
Thank you very much. Since you like the coffee and our products, would you like to visit our production line, Peter?
Yes, that would be very interesting because I used to be a plant manager.
Well, we can arrange sometimes an appointment for all the complete process in the coffee beans. From the green beans to the roasted coffee.
That would be very interesting.
Great.
Thank you. Do you also do the roasting here?
Yes, Peter, we do the roasting. To be exact, we import the green beans from the different countries of origin. We have a storage in the silos. After that, we produce for each origin a different profile of roasting. Correct and the best for the beans. After that, we blend the different origins in a different percentage to create a different type of blends.
That's interesting.
Yeah. Very interesting.
It's a good job, a nice job. So, sorry Peter, I have to go back to my work at the office. It has been a great pleasure to have you here. And we have to set the meeting for the production line. Hope I see you soon. Of course, the espressos and the coffees are up to me, on my bill. Hope I see you soon.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Ciao. Hi, Irene.
Bye, Stefano. See you soon. Thank you very much.
Thank you for coming.
Well, that was a lucky meeting, wasn't it, Peter?
It certainly was.
Well, okay, shall we go back to Business Voice now? And while we're on our way, I'll update you on all the courses and what we will be doing in the near future.
Yes, fine, let's go.
Yeah, and probably next time we'll be luckier and we'll be able to meet up with James too.
Good.
Episode 5, at the coffee shop. Grammar matters, simple future, shall, would.
Il simple future. Il futuro semplice viene usato per esprimere azioni future.
Next Sunday will be my birthday.
Domenica prossima sarà il mio compleanno.
I'll go to bed now.
Ora andrò a letto. Come si forma il simple future? Forma affermativa estesa e contratta. Il simple future è composto dal soggetto più will più l'infinito senza il to del verbo principale. Forma estesa.
I will drink. You will drink. He will drink. She will drink. It will drink. We will drink. You will drink. They will drink.
Forma contratta.
I'll drink. You'll drink. He'll drink. She'll drink. It'll drink. We'll drink. You'll drink. They'll drink.
Forma interrogativa. La forma interrogativa si forma con will più il soggetto più l'infinito senza il to del verbo principale.
Will I drink? Will you drink? Will he drink? Will she drink?
Will it drink? Will you drink? Will we drink? Will they drink?
Forma negativa, estesa e contratta. La forma negativa si forma col soggetto più will not più infinito senza il to del verbo principale. La forma contratta diventa won't. Forma estesa.
I will not drink. You will not drink. He will not drink. She will not drink. It will not drink. We will not drink. You will not drink. They will not drink.
Forma contratta.
I won't drink. You won't drink. He won't drink. She won't drink. It won't drink. We won't drink. You won't drink. They won't drink.
Shall. Shall, più infinito senza il to, viene usato per dare dei suggerimenti o per fare proposte.
Shall we go?
Andiamo.
Shall we have a drink?
Prendiamo un drink.
Shall I turn off the radio?
Spengo la radio. Would. Il would viene usato in inglese per formare il condizionale.
I would like a cup of tea.
Mi piacerebbe. Vorrei una tazza di tè.
That would be better.
Sarebbe meglio. Come si forma il condizionale? Forma affermativa estesa e contratta. Il condizionale presente è composto dal soggetto più would più l'infinito senza il to del verbo principale. Forma estesa.
I would go. You would go. He would go. She would go. It would go. We would go. You would go. They would go.
Forma contratta.
I'd go. You'd go. He'd go. She'd go. It'd go. We'd go. You'd go. They'd go.
Forma interrogativa. La forma interrogativa si forma con would più il soggetto più l'infinito senza il to del verbo principale.
Would I go? Would you go? Would he go? Would she go? Would it go? Would you go? Would we go? Would they go?
Forma negativa, estesa e contratta. La forma negativa si forma col soggetto più would not più l'infinito senza il to del verbo principale. Forma estesa.
I would not go. You would not go. He would not go. She would not go. It would not go. We would not go. You would not go. They would not go.
Forma contratta.
I wouldn't go. You wouldn't go. He wouldn't go. She wouldn't go. It wouldn't go. We wouldn't go. You wouldn't go. They wouldn't go.